Hello student, today we will learn about the paragraph formatting. So first we have to do, we have to select the text. Okay, so then you have to go to the home tab under this paragraph. Okay, so already you have 7 alignments are there. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, right, left. You have already seen that it's already the it's a left alignments by default is there. Then you can choose the center. Then you can right alignment. Now it's a justify sub. Okay, so all the alignment you can do. Okay, so in case of justified from the left and right hand both the side you can do. Okay, the space are also between the words are very good. Okay, so there are different shortcut key option also there. Okay, control. Right, control L, control R, control J. In this way, if you click from the keyboard, so justifications, right, left alignment, right alignment also, you can perform over here. Okay, now under the lines and spacing paragraph, okay, so by default, actually is 1.0, 1.5. You can see that between the lines, there's a space will be increased, okay. 1.15 is there, 1.5 is there, 2.0 is there. Okay, so as soon as I'm clicking, you can see the line, the space between the lines, it is increasing. Okay, so there is a line spacing option is also there. So under line spacing, single, exactly, single options are there, multiple option is there. Okay, so in this way also you can do, or you can from this particular list, you can choose over here also. Okay. Now, I'm choosing only one over right now. Okay. So, you can see the difference that how it is changing. Okay. Now, in case of doing indenting also can be done. Like, you have seen the cursor over here. That is a pointer. If you move this, then it will also, the text, when the starting of the text, it is denoting, it is actually working as a ruler. Okay. So, that particular ruler also you can adjust. So, from where actually the paragraph may starts. Okay. It's like first, the first line, I'm starting with this. So, initially, the top of the ruler, I have increased it from 0 to, I've increased to 2. Okay. Again, the second one also I can do. You can check. Okay. I'm increasing to up to 5. You said the first line is kept on 1 on 2. But the last one, the rest of the text that is there in the paragraph, it is shifted. 5 inches shifted. You can adjust it in at any point of time, whichever you feel like. Or equal the upper border, upper ruler, and lower ruler are placed. If it is same, then the whole, not only the first line, the all lines of the paragraph will be starting from there. Okay. Okay, so you can see if you are increasing both, then it is also be aligned like a previous how it is there from the previous one. Okay. Now you can change and you can see the modifications over here. Okay, I am again changed it and again I'm showing, I'm just increasing both the rulers, top ruler also and the bottom ruler also. Okay, so now again on the top ruler I am only moving. You are able to see what is the, okay, in this way. Now again I am moving it to the, from the beginning. Okay. So see, the first line I have increased, the rest of the line that I has there. So I have shorted. Okay. So it will be started from the next onwards. Okay. Now I have again shifted. So this, why I am actually keep on shifting, so that you can understand that how to do this kind of a shifting, how to you can indent your text according to your order. Okay. Okay. So 2 centimeter, the rest of the second part of the 3 part of the line, I have shifted to 2 centimeter. Now it again increasing to 5. Okay. You can check. Okay. Now again I am going to the top ruler or bottom ruler at the same position. Again with this top ruler and bottom ruler, both I am coming over here. Okay. So you can see the changes over here. Now under the paragraph group, the indentation also you can change using the options and how much from the left you can give a margin start. Okay, so I have 2.5. See, now using 2.5, it is already the top ruler that is we are moving. It is a, now it is a hanging one. Okay, so left and a hanging one is what? That first line, if you are able to see that I'm from the left, I'm increasing the value to 1 and I'm choosing over hanging. So the first line will be look like this. Where is the margin? It will be same. But the rest of the line will be hang from this one. Okay. Now only the first line you choose. The first line have increased. It is increased to the ruler and rest of the lines are keeping as same. So using the ruler also, you can do that. And without using the ruler, in case a paragraph option is also there. From here, you can do it. Both the way, you can do it. Okay. It's also very easy. You can do both the way using the ruler or else you can choose the option. Using that particular option, you can also do that. Okay. So now I hope you are able to understand the what is hanging, what is the first line of how can we change. Okay. Now we are from the line spacing. That's where single line spacing, how I have shown that, how to change a single line. There is a multiple line space also there. You can choose. Okay, before and after is also there, how much space you have to give before the paragraph start, after the paragraph ends. In this way, you can give a value also. You can see over there, as I'm increasing, as I'm decreasing, the space is also increasing and decreasing. Okay, if you click on okay, you can see this first paragraph is starting after this lines of space. After that, if you give before and after, in this way, you can check that how much gap you can give. You can see the gap just how we have given. Okay, this before, that is a 12 PT gap I have given. Okay, if you are increasing, so auto, it would automatically choose. Okay, click on auto. So automatically it is taking the gap. Okay, now you select the whole line and go to the corner for the indentation, and before auto, you can increase the value to 0. Okay, previously we have done auto, now it is 0. Now check how much space is given. Okay, so you can try it with the different option. Now paragraph we have done. Okay, now you have given the value. Okay, 12. Now it's 12 amount of space you have given. Now check how much gap is coming. Okay. So you can increase it also. You can decrease. Suppose 18 or 6 to 0. Any point of time. It is depends upon you that how much space you will give, you will not give. Okay. So I hope you are familiar with this particular symbols. It is a paragraph symbol pillow. Okay, so this are actually all about the formatting and indenting, and also like how to give a line spacing in Word. I hope this video is clear to you. Okay, thank you, student. I'm ending my lecture over here.